Hello everyone. Welcome back to Flat Earth Channel, where you can access the latest US news. Today news is about Trump. Trump condemns white supremacy, calls for mental health and gun reforms after double mass shootings.
We must seek real bipartisan solutions. We have to do that in a bipartisan manner that will truly make America safer and better for all. First, we must do a better job of identifying and acting on early warning signs. I am directing the Department of Justice to work in partnership with local, state, and federal agencies, as well as social media companies, to develop tools that can detect mass shooters before they strike. As an example, the monster in the Parkland High School in Florida had many red flags against him, and yet nobody took decisive action. Nobody did anything. Why not? Second, we must stop the glorification of violence in our society. This includes the gruesome and grisly video games that are now commonplace. It is too easy today for troubled youth to surround themselves with a culture that celebrates violence. We must stop or substantially reduce this, and it has to begin immediately. Cultural change is hard, but each of us can choose to build a culture that celebrates the inherent worth and dignity of every human life. That's what we have to do. Third, we must reform our mental health laws to better identify mentally disturbed individuals who may commit acts of violence, and make sure those people not only get treatment, but when necessary, involuntary confinement. Mental illness and hatred pulls the trigger, not the gun. Fourth, we must make sure that those judged to pose a grave risk to public safety do not have access to firearms, and that if they do, those firearms can be taken through rapid due process. That is why I have called for red flag laws, also known as extreme risk protection orders. Today, I'm also directing the Department of Justice to propose legislation ensuring that those who commit hate crimes and mass murders face the death penalty, and that this capital punishment be delivered quickly, decisively, and without years of needless delay.
Listening to the president, New Jersey Senator Cory Booker said Monday after Trump's speech, in comments shared on Twitter by his campaign manager, "Such a bull's tea soup of ineffective words. I will let the boss speak for himself." Another candidate, Representative Tim Ryan of Ohio, on Monday tweeted, "FCK me," after Trump mistakenly, at one point in his speech, said the Ohio shooting took place in Toledo. It happened in Dayton. For Ryan, the language appears to be part of a deliberate approach. Earlier Monday, the long-shot candidate went on CNN and tore into Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, saying, "Mitch McConnell needs to get off his ass and do something." On Sunday, he also tweeted, "Republicans need to get their ass together and stop pandering to the NRA. Period." Other Democrats trying to weigh in amid a storm of political reaction, like former Texas Representative Beto O'Rourke, are taking a similar approach. O'Rourke, who represented El Paso, the site of the shooting in Texas on Saturday, expressed his unvarnished anger when asked if he thinks Trump can make the situation better. "What do you think?" O'Rourke reportedly shot back at the press. "You know the S-dash-dash he's been saying. He's been calling Mexican immigrants rapists and criminals. I don't know, like, members of the press, what the F-dash-dash."
Oh, that there's a lot of injury, a lot of suffering in El Paso right now. I'm incredibly saddened, and it is very hard to think about this. I've had enough of this, especially living in a community where gunshots are all too regular. We have to, in this election, we have to have leaders that are willing to stand up and say, "I'm not going to let this issue be determined by what the interests of the corporate gun lobby are and the NRA.
Democratic leaders in Congress have called on Trump to support new gun restrictions and for McConnell to allow a vote in the GOP-controlled Senate on Democrat-supported gun control language that has passed in the House. In February, the new Democratic House majority promptly did its duty and passed the Bipartisan Background Checks Act of 2019, which is supported by more than 90% of the American people and proven to save lives, House Speaker Nancy Pelosi, D. California, and Senate Democratic Leader Chuck Schumer, D-N.Y., said in a joint statement after Trump's speech. However, Senate Republican leader Mitch McConnell has called himself a grim reaper and refuses to act on this bipartisan legislation. They added, "It is incumbent upon the Senate to come back into session to pass this legislation immediately." McConnell, in a statement Monday night, said, "Today, the president called on Congress to work in a bipartisan, bicameral way to address the recent mass murders which have shaken our nation. Senate Republicans are prepared to do our part." In his speech Monday, Trump did not call for explicit changes to gun laws beyond so-called red flag laws that would take guns from those deemed a public risk. However, he said he is open and ready to listen to ideas that will actually work. But in a statement that riled Democrats, he said, "Mental illness and hatred pulls the trigger, not the gun." However, mental health experts, including representatives from the American Psychological Association, have called it unfounded to blame mass shootings on mental illness in place of considering other possible factors, such as hate, bigotry, and access to assault weapons. "Calling every mass shooting a mental health problem is inaccurate and it's stigmatizing," said Arthur Evans, chief executive officer of the American Psychological Association. "Mental illness affects millions of adults across the country. About 1 in 5 adults in the United States, or 46.6 million, experience mental illness in a given year, according to the National Alliance on Mental Illness. The Mental Health Stigma and Violence 853, the reality is that there are a variety of reasons that mass shootings happen," Evans said. "If this were a mental health issue and this was the only issue involved here, what you would see is roughly the same number of mass shootings around the world, and we're not seeing that. Framing mass shootings as a mental health issue certainly could lead to policies aimed at improving mental health, but it won't prevent the next shooter," said Laurie Ann Post, a professor of emergency medicine and medical social sciences at Northwestern University's Feinberg School of Medicine, who studies violence and policy. "It's estimated that less than 5% of shootings are committed by people with a diagnosable mental illness," Post said. Thanks for listening. Please subscribe our channel to update the latest news in America. Brazilian gang leader tried to escape from prison by dressing up as his daughter when she visited him behind bars and walking out the penitentiary's main door in her place, authorities said Sunday. But prison officials said the nervousness displayed by Clovino da Silva, also known as Shorty, as he tried to leave the prison in the western part of Rio de Janeiro dressed as a woman gave him away. His plan was apparently to leave his 19-year-old daughter inside the jail. Police are looking into her possible role as an accomplice in Saturday's failed escape attempt from Garichino prison. Rio's state secretary of prison administration released photos Sunday showing Da Silva in a silicone girl's mask and long dark-haired wig, wearing tight jeans and a pink shirt. They also released a video in which Da Silva can be seen removing the mask and some of the clothes, and saying his full name. Authorities say Da Silva was part of the leadership of the Red Command, one of the most powerful criminal groups in Brazil that controlled drug trafficking in a large part of Rio. After the failed escape bid, Da Silva was transferred